This is certainly worth putting on tape. I was sitting in church today, and I suddenly realized that all the people there, none of them were bound by their form, what their appearance was. I realized that everyone's actually pure light. No one has any particular actual form at all. We're all actually formless. And I didn't hold anybody to what their appearance was. I said, because we're not actually bound by our appearance at all. It's all just an appearance. And this just like, there's this realization, I just saw it, I said, wow. I said, okay, all right, that's good. The whole world, that is true. In fact, everything, that is true. And I realized that this is the vision of oneness that I had. That was why I felt so happy, because I realized nobody in the slightest way has ever been, or ever will be, or is now, bound by their bodily appearance in any way. And so it's possible to not see people as their body, actually, as the, while they're appearing, because they could appear any which way at all, and even that would not be them. So what we are cannot be defined by any appearance whatsoever. And this realization, you know, dawned on me. And I was, okay, all right, it's good. So I realized, wow, that's a big one, isn't it? That's a very big realization. And it was just a brief little glimpse of that. I just said, hey, I see this is true. Wow, hey, okay. It was just for an instant like that, just an instant. But that's an attention getter. That is really an attention getter when you can realize this. So I say it is good to get around groups of people like this on a regular basis, where I just sort of had the opportunity to say, hey, wait a minute. There's all these different people. I don't know any of them really. They don't know me. I don't know them. All different races, nationalities, backgrounds, you name it. It's just a very diverse mix of people. And I said, none of these appearances are what anyone is whatsoever. Not at all. Never will be. Holy cow. The continuity fear comes up, and then the ego starts asking questions. Well, what about this person? What about, you know? But I saw it as a totality. It's just a general principle here. It's a general principle. This is certainly what the vision of oneness is going towards. I remember in the vision of oneness I had previously, everybody seemed the same. They all seemed like kind of some light body. Actually, everybody was just like this form of light, light in the form of a body, sort of an outline. By sort of glowing, like there was a glowing outline of these forms, and that's all I saw. I didn't see features of anybody actually. And this is the right way, what way to see. You know, in other words, what we are is not defined by any appearance whatsoever. So you see somebody, you know, old person there, you know, that's not what they are at all. They're not. You don't. So don't see them as that. Okay, they're the living light itself, actually. As is everyone. Nobody is defined by their appearance. Because any appearance can be instantly changed into anything else. And even that isn't what anyone is, right? If any appearance is just an appearance can be changed into anything, how can we define, say, this is what we are? We cannot define it. So it is possible to get to glimpse this, at least glimpse it, and hopefully realize it permanently. But it's one thing to talk about it here, and it's another thing to be out in public and actually recognize it and say, hey, yeah. So I do suggest getting out in public in certain situations like I was, and just, you're able to, it lends itself to certain, I've had certain breakthroughs actually, not because of what they're teaching in church at all. It just happened, I happen to be there and I take the opportunity, that kind of thing. Well, you can do it, anywhere actually. And it's important of freeing everyone from their appearance, the body, free them from the body. Don't view them as a body. Whatever bodily appearance someone has, that's not them. That's not them. Don't hold anybody to how their body appears at all. And then you will feel like very happy, actually. It says, wow, we're all just light. I'm light too. I'm not held in my appearance either. We're the light itself, you know. Now, so you can see this in public, and I didn't, you know, nobody had any idea that I recognized this. No idea whatsoever. No need to draw attention to yourself. Sometimes it's very good to be in a place where everybody's supposed to be well behaved and nobody's supposed to draw attention to themselves, because then you can have a tremendous realization and you realize, hey, you know, I just got to, you know, I can't draw attention to myself, so I just have to maintain very steadiness, calm steadiness. It actually is beneficial. It's actually beneficial. There is someone today who is acting up. You know, this happened a couple times, actually. A couple times, and somebody was acting up. They were just standing when they're supposed to sit. They're standing up and they were saying stuff out loud, you know, and obviously something was not right. And, you know, the priest just ignores it and just keeps going on. Everybody just ignores it. And it kept taking place, and it was just, you know, sort of inappropriate, drawing attention into himself, so it's extremely. And then eventually someone went over, I guess, and they just talked to him, they sat down, still acted out a little bit, but not so much, and then people just, you know, everything just kept going on. Well, obviously, when you're in a situation where you're not supposed to act out, it can be helpful. You don't want to stand up and say, hey everybody, I just realized you are all light, you know. I just realized we're all light, we're not bodies at all, no one's bound to a body. No one's bound to any appearance in the slightest bit. Nobody is bound to any appearance in the slightest bit. You are not bound to appearances. Well, if I had said that, the priest would have just kept right on talking. They just ignore anyone acts up, they just ignore it. Completely ignore it. And just keep on going and you know, doing what they're doing, and the whole thing just keeps going along. And, you know, they don't stop it. I mean, I remember this, somebody fainted, somebody collapsed or fainted or something, and these people were attending to her, and it's like a scary situation, actually, and the priest just kept right on, like nothing had happened, didn't break stride for 1 second. So, if anything happens, the congregation has to take care of it. The priest doesn't stop what they're doing, they don't. Some sort of moth. Attracted to the light. Attracted to the light. Be attracted to the light. See? Here comes something that is attracted to the light. We are all free. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me to be. We are not bodies. We are free. We are still spirit, exactly as God created us to be. We are spirit, formless spirit. So nobody, never see anybody think that that an appearance that you're seeing identifies what we are in the slightest bit. Does not. Mere appearance, designed to identify threat, help identify threat, that's all. See if anything else. This is a milestone, a very important milestone. It can be reached in at least, it's just in a little glimpse, but I was willing for a moment, just willing for a moment to see, to release everyone from all appearances. Release everything, actually, but specifically people. But don't hold anybody to whatever appearance they are, they happen to have. Some people, glamorous people, think they found the right appearance. What they are saying, this is what I am, this is what I am. Of course, that appearance will go through aging and all these things. You don't have to say that people don't have to have an appearance. They don't. They want to have an appearance. It's just that nobody's bound to any appearance at all. There's no binding power. Appearance has no power to bind. No power to bind. There is no power in appearance, actually. No binding power at all. None. But to try and intellectualize, get this intellectually, it's way beyond that. It's just like there's a willingness there within me to see it that way. I said, hey, why don't I see it this way? And then right away, I felt like this is true. It was very impersonal. It was just a generalized, impersonal realization. Because it's quite true that this appearance here is not binding on spirit in the slightest bit. This appearance could change instantly into something completely different. No appearance is bound moment by moment by moment to the next moment. There is no appearance that's bound to the next moment at all. Nothing is bound to the next moment in any way. In any way. We're just pretending that there's some law like that. There isn't. And it was just, it's very refreshing just to feel like, you know what, nobody's bound at all. Somehow that gives spirit that's what spirit loves to see. It's so much relief for spirit to see that. Not only that like I'm not bound, but that no one else is bound either, you see. No one is bound in the slightest bit. That is what spirit wants to see. That's the vision of oneness. And that definitely is going to give rise to just a joy, a real great joy. So hopefully I'm able to allow that to, you know, arise and view the world that way. That's my goal. That is my goal for sure. So I just have to keep working on it and reach the goal. So, all right. This is just the late night update. Huge milestone is reached on the spiritual path. Really fantastic news. Anybody in the world at any, you know, to actually get a glimpse of this is huge news, really. It's very good news for everybody in the world. that a mind, a spirit in this world is managed to get enough willingness to see it that way, just for an instant. That means everybody can eventually, you know, if you just evaporate your continuity fear enough, these are the advances that start showing up. You're not afraid to at least give it a try and say, let me just see. Wow, this is great, you know, I like that. Okay, very great, that's it for this video.